Hi guys, so in this video I'm going to share 3 amazing breakfast ideas using oat flour. Oats are rich in fiber and all other nutrients, and it makes the healthiest, tastiest and most fulfilling breakfast recipes ever. You can buy oat flour from the store, but I make it at home using rolled oats. It's super easy to make and can be stored for multiple uses. So basically you will have to blitz it up in your mixer grinder and you will get this fine powder which you can store in an airtight container, and I just make a big batch of it and store it up for a month or so. So to make the flour, I use rolled oats and I pour it in a liquid grinding jar. It is super soft, so after just blitzing it up for 1 or 2 minutes, the super fine powder is ready. I usually store it in a glass jar and then I use it for up to a month, and yeah, the flour is ready. So the first recipe of the day is a oat flour bread, which you can use to make a burger or a sandwich. So to make 2 slices of bread or 1 burger bun, you usually need 4 tablespoons of the flour. I don't follow an accurate measurement, but yeah, usually I take 4 to 5 tablespoons of the flour. Next, I add some baking powder to the mix to fluff up the bread, and I also add a pinch of salt to bring out the taste. So basically that's all the dry ingredients, and then I mix them up together very well before adding any wet ingredient. So I add a tablespoon of oil to this and 1 whole egg, which basically adds a good dose of protein to this mixture. And then I also add some vanilla essence to, you know, give it a very nice kind of fragrance. And then yeah, I mix them all up together to make a thick paste. So this won't be like any cake batter, this will be thicker than that. You kind of keep on mixing it all together and then at the end you will get a thick paste. So this is how the batter looks like finally. It's thick and uniformly mixed. And now I will transfer it to my microwave safe bowl. So you can choose a square bowl if you want a square slices of bread. I wanted to make a burger, so I decided to transfer the mixture in a round bowl. And I also topped the mixture with some flaxseed. It's not a necessary step, but yeah, you can do it if you want your breads to look very fancy. And yeah, my mixture is ready to go into the microwave. So for this bread, you don't need any preheated oven, just a very basic microwave mode will do the job. So this is a new microwave machine in my home and I was struggling a little bit with it. But yeah, usually I put this mixture in and then in the highest power setting, I just put it in for 2 minutes. If the bread is not fluffy enough, you can give 30 seconds more, but yeah, usually 2 minutes is enough for this bread to be fluffed up and ready. So my bread was ready after 2 minutes. It was all fluffed up and then I transferred it on a plate and got 2 slices out of it. I'm sorry in advance for my knife skills, they're very basic, but yeah, the pieces were not even, but I got 2 slices out of this and made my burger bun. So you can put in any filling inside your burger. I just kept it very simple on the day because I was very hungry. So I toasted up the burger buns in a hot pan. I do it just to get rid of the wetness and give it a toasty kind of flavor. This is not compulsory again, but I love my bread a little toasted. So then I added a mint chili chutney in the slices of the burger, which is my current favorite. And then I also added a slice of paneer to make it a little more filling and tasty, and then topped it off with some salt and pepper. And that's my breakfast burger, super tasty and super healthy. So the next recipe is my most favorite. It's the oat flour pancakes, and they're perfect for indulging on a holiday. And the recipe is very simple. So for this one, you have to add all the dry ingredients first. For this, I'm taking a cup of oat flour, and to this mixture, I added a teaspoon of baking powder, some salt to taste, and some sugar. That's pretty much all the dry ingredients, and then I mixed up all of them together. For the liquid ingredients, I added a cup of cashew milk. I make all these vegan milks at home, and do let me know if you want those recipes. Now, to the milk, I added 2 whole eggs. Next, I added 1 tablespoon of white oil in this mixture. I am using sunflower oil. You can use coconut oil or any other seed oil if you want to. I also added some apple cider vinegar because that actually makes the pancake way more fluffier. And then I added some vanilla essence to this mixture, and that's pretty much all the liquid ingredients. After whisking all the liquids together well, just pour this liquid mixture into the dry ingredients and then mix that together till you get a cake batter kind of consistency. So it won't be very thin, but it won't be very thick either. It will be sort of a very runny kind of texture. So as you can see, this batter is ready. I was making it as a holy special breakfast, so I made it in 4 different colors. I just poured the mixture in 4 different bowls, and then I kept one regular color, and then added spirulina powder to one of the bowls to get the green color, some cocoa powder in one of the mixtures to get a brown color, and some beetroot powder in one of the mixtures to get a red color. So you can actually also use artificial coloring, but I think this is the best. They are nutritious stuffs and also add fun colors to your food. So the batters are ready, and now it's time to make our delicious pancakes. Now to make the pancakes, brush a non-stick pan with a very little amount of oil, and then add 2 or 3 spoons of the pancake batter. Don't add very little or a lot of it. Just add a moderate amount of it so that your pancakes are not very thick or not very thin. Now you can try to spread the batter uniformly to give it a somewhat round shape, and allow the batter to set for a few seconds. Then you can cover the pot and let the pancake cook for a minute. Now after a minute, remove the lid to see how the pancake looks. You will know if it's cooked. You will see these small tiny bubbles on the top. It means that the lower side of the pancake is cooked and it's ready for a flip. Just make sure that you loosen up the edges a little bit before you flip it. And yeah, just be very careful because at times they break. You know, not all your pancakes are perfect. But yeah, try not to break it, and just flip it to cook the other side. So the other side does not take a long time to cook, so remove it from the pan after 20-30 seconds, and yeah, your pancake is ready. This is how I made all the pancakes, and yeah, this is how they looked like. So you can top off your pancakes with any fruit of your choice and any sweetener like honey or maple syrup. I did not add any fruit on that day because I was having a late breakfast and 4 pancakes were heavy enough for me. I just added some honey on top to, you know, get some extra sweetness. And yeah, that's how I enjoyed my pancakes without any guilt. They were amazing in taste, and yeah, I think they were pretty nutritious compared to other regular pancakes. So the third recipe is the easiest to make. I call it my oat flour smoothie. You don't need to cook anything basically for this recipe. You just have to keep it in the fridge overnight, and the next morning you will get this delicious cold breakfast ready. And I think you will enjoy this recipe for the upcoming summer days. And yeah, so let's see how I made it. So I took 2 or 3 spoons of oat flour in a bowl. Again, the amount may vary according to how thick you want your smoothie to be. I did not want it to be very thick, so I added 3 spoons of the oat flour. And then to this mixture, I added cashew milk. So this is how the mixture of the milk and flour looks like. When you keep this mixture in the fridge overnight, this kind of thickens up a bit. If you add lesser milk, this will be like a very thick paste. I normally prefer my smoothie to be a little runny, especially this one. So I add a little more milk than required, nearly 3/4 cup of milk. Next, I added some chocolate powder to this mixture. I forgot to make a paste of the chocolate powder before adding it to the smoothie because that makes the mixing process quite easy. But I forgot to do that, and as I added the powder directly to the smoothie mixture, I needed some time to get it mixed. So yeah, finally I was able to mix the cocoa powder into the smoothie mixture. And then I also added a very little amount of coffee to this mixture because it gives a kind of bitterness which I love. It's not compulsory, you can totally skip it, but I love it. And then again I added some vanilla essence because I love it. So after the mixture was ready, I kept it in the fridge overnight. So the next morning, the consistency was like this, which was perfect for me. If you find your smoothie mixture to be very thick, you can always add some milk to this, and then you can add a sweetener of your choice. I added some honey to this mixture. You actually don't need to add a lot because you already have some milk which has its own sweetness, and then you can also add some fruits to this. So I also added some banana to this smoothie mixture. And then I also added some muesli for some extra crunch. Finally added a lot of seed mixture to it to add some more crunch and nutrition. And that's it, the smoothie was ready. So I hope you love all these recipes. Do let me know if you give them a try, and let me know which one is your favorite. Thank you, bye bye.